G'day, and welcome to another great program. We're taking you all around South Australia for the best we have to offer in fishing, boating, and in fact, anything that involves the water. Coming up, salmon fishing near Wedge Island, diving off Kangaroo Island, cooking prawns the right way, and giving the little fellas another chance and test driving a couple of tricky little boats. Okay, straight into it with Shane Mensforth, off Wedge Island, in Southern Spencer Gulf.
Last week we were catching nanny guy and groper from the Faley. Now it's time for something completely different. It's been blowing pretty hard outside, so I've decided to head inshore for some calmer water.
Well, we've decided to get off the Faley, put the small boat in the water. We're in quite close to Wedge Island, and we've come across a patch of salmon. Now you can see the couple of guys behind me hooked up. It's mayhem on here at the moment. They're not huge fish, about 2 kilos, but they really know how to fight, as you can see by what's happening behind me here.
Salmon will take a variety of lures, such as diving minnows, metal slices, and even rubber tails. But today they're jumping on just about anything we throw at them. Both overhead and threadline reels are fine for this sort of fishing. All you need is some 6 to 8 kilo line, a shortish rod, and you're in with a really good chance. We're only in a couple of metres of water here, and that really makes the salmon go hard. Australian salmon aren't true salmon at all. They're not related in any way to those fantastic Atlantic salmon we pay top dollar for in the restaurants.
Oh, nearly got him.
But they're close relatives of the humble Tommy Rudd.
Yeah, they are straight back behind us.
You'll find them in the surf, around ocean rocks, and at times lurking around offshore islands like Wedge.
He's got a triple hook up here, this could end up in anything. He's got to do some fancy promo, fancy footwork here.
Cooperation's obviously important when you've got this many guys fishing. Watch out for those flying lures. Releasing salmon's a good way to go these days. They're not a flash fish to eat by any means, so enjoy them on the line, then throw them back if you don't want them. We've let plenty of salmon go, and we've kept one or two. It's been a day these guys will never forget.
Now this may look like a normal echo sounder transducer, but watch this. It comes off, and it goes back on again just as easily. This is part of the very clever Humminbird portable echo sounder system, which has been very popular in the Northern Territory with barramundi fishermen for years and is slowly finding its way down here into South Australia. Now the portable units run on twin 6-volt torch batteries, which means you can operate this unit in your boat without having to have a 12-volt system, and that's very handy. If you don't actually want to buy one of these compact units, you can go to the guys at Glasscraft and hire one for a day or a week or as long as you like, and that gives you the try before you buy option, which is a very good idea. These Humminbird compacts have a terrific LCD screen. In fact, they'll do just about everything that the more expensive units will do. Well done, Humminbird. Another great idea.
Well, tying a loop into the end of a piece of rope, a lot of people will just tie a knot in the rope like that. And sure, you've got a loop there, and it's strong enough, but you'll never get it undone. It's what I call a shotgun knot. You need a shotgun to get it undone after it's had a bit of load on it. The proper thing to do is to tie a bowline. Go around whatever you're tying it onto, put a loop in over the top of the rope like that, go down through that loop over the top of this piece of rope here, and then back up through there, pull it tight, and there it is. And that would be one of my favourite knots. It's strong and easy to undo, good one to work with.
G'day, mate.
The Truman Show's Jim Carrey is Lloyd, and he's dumb.
Yeah!
Jeff Daniels is Harry, and he's dumber. From the makers of that movie about Mary, Dumb and Dumber, Sunday on 7.
When you're looking for slate, you go straight to Stonecraft. But did you know Stonecraft also have a fantastic range of Marflore genuine timber? Hard-wearing deco step laminates, quality Marstone sandstone, and wall facing. Stonecraft. What a range, what a choice. And right now, you can save on oak laminate by DecoStep. Just $39 a metre. Stonecraft. One location only. For sales, installation and savings.
I've got one.
And you can get one with help from your locally operated Got One store. Enjoy the fishing experience. Still one of the most popular pastimes in Australia. Soak up the great outdoors. Take your family fishing today. And you don't need any experience to have a great time. And we have more than just fishing tackle. All quality brand products. So if you want to catch that big one, see your Got One store today. He's got one. Got One Fishing Tackle. With stores across Australia, there's got to be one near you.
Oh, my cat ate the mouse.
So where do you go for a new mouse? Dick Smith Electronics. Keyboards, joysticks, or anything else to do with computers?
That's where you go.
Dick Smith Electronics.
That's where you go.
If you're planning a wedding, book your formal wear this month at Farrings. And regardless of the wedding date, you can hire from just $49 per outfit. That's a saving of $41. But hurry, it's for bookings made this month only at Ferrari Formal Wear.
Want to buy or sell a car? Now there's a better way and it's simple. See? Auto Supermarket Weekly. Look, full colour pictures of your car, 4x4, ute, motorcycle, light, commercial, boat or caravan. We'll send our photographer to you and it's all included in the price. $60 for 2 weeks or advertise for as little as $20. Call Auto Supermarket Weekly on 1300 36 97 98. Auto Supermarket Weekly, our pictures worth 1,000 words.
Welcome back. It's boat test time, and this week, a little beauty from Quintrex.
This is a 5 metre sea breeze from Quintrex.
Now, it's made up in Queensland, but I reckon it'd be perfect for down here in South Oz as well. It's designed for family boating, for things like snorkeling and fishing. We've got about 10 knots of northerly wind here today, so we'll take it out of the Gulf. We'll really put this boat through its paces for you.
One of the friendliest features of a boat like the Seabreeze is that it's so easy to launch and to operate. This can be a one-person boat with the right trailer. I really like the zip-up canopy from Harris Motor Trimmers. It lets the air in on a warm day and provides excellent all-round visibility. The Quintrex has got a deeply flared bow and very broad chines, and these make for very positive handling. Conditions for our test run were pretty calm, but we did find a rather large tugboat wake to play with. This enabled us to test the boat's capabilities in lumpy water. As you can see, the Seabreeze copes very well with a decent wave, landing quite softly and throwing that spray well away from the cockpit. The 70 horse Yamaha is pretty much a perfect power match for the Seabreeze. Top speed over calm water is around 32 knots, and that's plenty. I prefer driving from a standing position at times, and the Seabreeze seating allows this very comfortably. Stability at rest is very good for a lightweight boat, and that's great news for fishermen. And here's that tugboat wake again. At 25 knots, I was able to cross it with absolute confidence. And retrieving, well, it's just a piece of cake. The Seabreeze comes with flush-mounted rod holders, a half-pod output mount with twin boarding platforms, an elevated battery shelf, and a handy glove compartment. It's also got an enormous cockpit for a boat of this size.
Well, the Seabreeze is about as good as we thought it was going to be. Great little boat from Quintrex.
Most people who go fishing will have a reason at some stage or another to release a fish back into the water. It may be because the fish is undersized. It may be because they practice this new idea of catch and release. Some people have even been known to kiss a fish before they do that. I'd like to talk with Richard today about some of the ways that we can do that properly.
Yeah, well, Andrew, one of the most important things realistically is the time it takes. You don't want the fish out of the water for too long. So what we've got a bring on the line today. We'll take it out, we'll go through a few little steps and just try and show everybody the best way to release the fish in the water.
Okay.
So we'll just bring this one in. What we've got here is a nice little Port River brim. First thing you notice, we've got a rag down here. Now this rag's actually a wet rag.
Right.
So what we're doing is we can cut the fish up nicely with the wet rag.
Why does the rag have to wet?
It protects the fish. A lot of the fish have got a protective mucus coating over them. Most people would notice, especially with King George whiting, it's a very, very thick mucus. Our hands are dry. We might have sunscreens, mosquito repellents, which really are things that we don't want the fish to absorb through its flesh and through its skin. In this case, we can just keep the fish nice and moist. We've got the hook here. Now, that hook comes out pretty easily. We're actually using a barbless hook,
okay,
which I think is a great way to go. If, in fact, you want to use the proper hooks with the barb on there, what I suggest is sometimes if you're trying to get the hook out, you'll find that the barb gets caught. Whatever you do, don't yank the fish.
Right.
Some small fish like Tommy Ruff, you'll actually pull the whole mouth out. They're very, very soft mouth fish.
Okay.
If you've got a problem, cut the line. So what we're going to do, I'll get this little fella back in the water now. The other thing is we've got a little bit of a drop here, but what we do is we don't throw the fish back in.
Right.
We want to get as close to the water as we can. In this case, I'm just above the water, and off she's gone. No problems at all.
We're on the Chapman River today. Kim, tell us a bit about the river and what we'd like you to catch.
Well, the sea's actually 200 metres that way.
Uh-huh.
We're going to go upstream a bit to one of my favourite brim spots. The thing we're most likely to catch would be brim, maybe the chance of a bigger mullet.
And can you guarantee me a brim or a kilo?
Oh, I can't guarantee, but we'll try.
We'll try. Well, Kim, how about here, mate?
Well, if we go up a bit further, there's an old log in the water that should produce some bigger fish.
Ah, this is where the 1 kilo fish come from, is that
right? That's
right,
yeah.
Okay, let's do it. That's good just here.
Old log's just...
I'm about to try and catch a brim. Instead of using a traditional running ball or bean sinker, I've discovered that something that makes life a lot easier for brim fishermen. It's called a sea sinker, and it's made in Adelaide by a rather clever fella called Bob Prime. It works like this. Instead of threading the sinker straight onto the main line, you've got this little plastic sleeve, and Dino, you're going to have to be right onto the ball to see me doing this. But it slips onto the main line, moves up and down, and then the sinker just slides down over that sleeve, and presto, you've got a running sinker without having to cut the main line and retie it. It's one of the cleverest things I've seen on tackle for a long time, and it's nice to think that South Australians can come up with ideas like this. Fantastic sea sinkers. Salmon trout. It wasn't even a brim. He's not a big brim. In fact, he's quite a small brim. I don't mind using pieces of pilchard for brim. They're quite a good bait. So I'd cut the pilchard off through that section, 3 or 4 centimetres back from the tail. When I'm going to bait it up, I'll grab the hook, pass it all the way through, pull the line through after it, and then push the pointed barb well into the fish, bring it back through, so it's sticking out like that, and then put a small half hitch around the pilchard's tail. I don't know if you're getting that, Dean, but you can see I've pulled the line right through, holding the tail. It's nice and secure, you can cast that well, and the little guys won't rip it off. It's a good bait. A little bit better. It's getting towards almost half legal. The sun's trying to break through at last and the wind's down a bit. We've caught a few brim here this afternoon, nothing too big, but a lot of fun. Chapman River, KI, great place for the family, very accessible, good for the serious fishermen too. Well, let's see, a 30 pound I reckon here, mate. Have a look at this. Oh, what a perler. Chapman River, big brim.
In just a minute from FAB South of Oz, diving off Kangaroo Island. But first, the latest from Seven Nightly News.
Hi everyone, on the news coming up shortly, a freak accident hits one of Australia's best-known tourist attractions. Mark Taylor puts personal glory aside for the sake of the team and Kate Winslet's wedding plans. Nobody knows news
like Seven. Before you put to sea, see Quinns. They've got the boat of your dreams for sailing, cruising, fishing, diving, socialising and family fun. Plus, Quinns have a huge range of chandlery, charts, clothing, motors and safety gear, including radios and all your marine electronics. Quinns' wide range of quality brands are all backed by professional advice, installation and service facilities.
See you soon.
Call Quinns for the best of everything marine.
Wait for it. Wait for Saturday. Select carpets will be sold at half price. Rugs will be sold at half price. Vinyl floor will be sold at half price. Look for the green price tags. Save Saturday, Sunday and Monday.
If you're looking for a car and want something small, comfortable and economical, go for a car loan that's a teeny mini car loan from the Credit Union for South Australians. Savings and loans.
In Australia, what impressed me most was the Outback.
Ah.
I came to appreciate this quality so much, I brought it back with me.
When you're looking for a patio, carport or pergola, look no further than the all-Australian Stratco Outback. Look at the range of options, new styles, wider cover, a bigger choice of features. All designed to suit your individual needs at a price to suit your budget.
Australians are so lucky to have the magnificent Outback.
Phone now and let an authorised Stratco dealer show you the magnificent Outback.
Where do you go when a possum sits on your TV antenna?
Dick Smith Electronics. That's where you go. We've got a great range of audio equipment. PCs, printers, scanners, fax machines and all the parts. That's where you go. Want to get on the internet? Here's a modem, a star kit and all that goes with it. So next time you need something electronic, Dick Smith Electronics. That's where you go.
When it comes to water sport, Kangaroo Island has it all, as a rather nervous Steve Whittam found out.
You've been fishing all day and nothing has been biting, so you're wondering what's going on down there. Maybe it's time for you to get in and find out for yourself. Now, Jim Thistleton from KI Diving is going to take us down, have a quick squeeze underneath for Clara and my first dive. Is there anything we should be concerned about here, Jim?
Oh, mate, there's no real concerns, just some safeguards. And we'll look after you in that department. We'll go through it now, what you need to do. And then we'll go into the water and you'll know exactly what's going to happen, where we're going to go and what's going to go.
You're not worried, are you, Clara?
No, not at all. Just about the coldness.
Why are you
just
worried?
We run along the north coast of the island, generally between Western River Cove and Cape Border. Sometimes we come down towards Middle River. The backdrop is a spectacular scenery. The cliffs there up to 600-700 feet high, mostly where we work. Stuck on this one to try.
Great.
There's them up for you. There's the. Thank you much.
Please stay up there.
There. I'll catch you as you come. Hold on. Leafy sea the dragon is a unique creature. It's found only in southern Australian waters. And we would see him, I guess, on an average of once every 2 days. People get to swim with the sea lions, and then mostly with the fur seals. The lions aren't quite as often as the fur seals. They will interact with you very well as long as you follow a protocol that we've learned to develop.
Really refreshing, sensational. Just beautiful scenery out of the water. Did you see the sea lion?
Yeah.
You did. Didn't think it was me.
No.
Jim? Stunning stuff, stunning.
Well, today on the menu, we've got something very delicious for you from Manny's and the Adelaide Produce Markets. So, Dee, tell us all about it.
We're cooking prawn, coriander and chilli noodles, which is a great entree dish.
Mm-hmm. Something just right for summer, hey?
Yeah.
And the prawns, Lula?
Yes, they're fresh South Australian green prawns. Very popular dish at Manny's.
So, Judy, tell us about the fresh ingredients from the Adelaide Produce Markets.
Okay, now we've got some olive oil, chilli, ginger, some red capsicum, spring onions, the noodles, of course, we've got some sauces, and the coriander, which just goes so well with seafood and prawns also.
Mm-hmm.
We've got some sauces as well.
So just tell me about these sauces, what are they?
It's fish sauce,
soya sauce, and some fresh lime juice.
Love limes.
Great.
Okay, give me some directions, girls.
Okay.
What are we doing?
First thing that we're doing is we're adding the oil.
So the pan should be fairly hot. Yep. Is that hot enough, do you reckon?
Yeah, it's good.
Yep, okay.
Okay, we'll put in the spring onions.
Give them a bit of a stir.
Sizzling away.
Look at this. You'll make an expert
the
out of
ginger.
Me yet.
Oh, well, I'm trying. The chilli.
Chilli. Well, you've got to have chilli in this
dish.
Oh,
and it just really finishes it off. It's just great. Mm-hmm.
Now, that's okay. All in together. How
that's
long do we let
together.
That settle for?
That only sort of needs about a minute or not even that, because we don't want to overcook the vegetables.
Just so they're nice and crunchy still.
That's right. Now we'll put in the prawns.
Lula, that's your job.
That's right, Steve. And you know when your prawns are cooked, when they turn a pink colour.
Jude, when do we need to add the other bits?
Now we need to add the noodles.
Mm-hmm. Excellent.
Put them in. They won't take
just buy
very
these
long.
Anywhere?
Yeah, you can buy them in the supermarket or in fruit and vegetable shops even.
And why cook this at home when you can come here to Manny's and have it freshly served for you?
That's right, yes.
Smells great. Now we add the fresh coriander. Mm-hmm. It just finishes it off, gives it a beautiful flavour.
This is a very oriental dish, really, for a fish restaurant.
Okay, and now we'll add the lime juice.
Oh, yes.
And that's it.
That's it?
That's
we're
it.
Done.
Ready to
now
serve.
We're ready to serve.
Nice and pink there, guys. All ready to serve, and I think that's your job because I'll only do that with much mess. That's a very delicate sort of thing.
Beautiful.
Serving up food, isn't it?
Yes, it's women's work, isn't it, Steve?
It's what?
So, women's work.
Women's work. Oh, okay. You insist. I'm just going to eat it, that's all. It's a 50-50 thing here.
Yeah.
You serve it up, are you?
Oh, yeah. And some fresh coriander.
Lovely.
Now,
beautiful.
There it is. It's prawns, coriander, and chili noodles. If you'd like the recipe, check out our website.
Most people who've got a boat on a mooring similar to this would know that you need a bow line and a stern line to hold the boat there securely. This one's got about a 12mm silver rope on the bow line there. It's maybe a little bit slack, but that's not too bad. There's another option too. If you want to stop your boat moving forward and aft too much, you can try using springer lines. Now this boat's luckily got a cleat in the centre there, and he's got some short ropes going to his forward cleat and one down the back on the mooring here. If your boat doesn't happen to have a cleat in the centre there, you can always just run a rope right from the stern all the way up to your front cleat. And remember, if you're not on a floating mooring like this one, you need to allow for the maximum rise and fall of the tide, so have some extra slack in your ropes. Even if you're on the Murray, you often get fairly decent wind tides blowing up just from the effects of the wind on the water.
...6.30 tonight on John Riddell's World Around Us.
We can basically go wherever we want, whenever we want, without being detected.
Join us on a journey deep below the sea.
Anything could go wrong at any time.
The World of a Submariner. Submarine premieres tonight.
I've got one!
I've got one!
I've got one!
And you can get one with help from your locally operated Got One store. Enjoy the fishing experience. Still one of the most popular pastimes in Australia. Soak up the great outdoors. Take your family fishing today. And you don't need any experience to have a great time. And we have more than just fishing tackle. All quality brand products. So if you want to catch that big one, see your Got One store today. He's got one. He's got one. And he's got one. Got One Fishing Tackle. With stores across Australia, there's got to be one near you.
If you're planning a wedding, book your formal wear this month at Ferraris, and regardless of the wedding date, you can hire from just $49 per outfit. That's a saving of $41. But hurry, it's for bookings made this month only at Ferrari Formal Wear.
This is a demonstration to show how new Lawn Tamer from Yates slows the growth of your lawn. You'll only have to mow it half as often, and the lawn will become thicker and lusher. Watch. We might need some help here. Thank you, ladies. See? New Lawn Tamer from Yates. A beautiful lawn you mow half as often.
Look again. It's sale time at Casabella with great savings on all leather lounges. Choose from dozens of styles and colours. So for the ultimate in leather luxury at prices you can afford. Look again and save at Casabella, 472 Paynham Road, Glynd.
Does your home have tired, dirty old roof tiles? Jazz up your roof with Boral. Here's the points to note on your Boral quote. Pressure clean. Replace broken tiles. Rebed and repoint capping. triple coat colour system, including Boral's exclusive Glow Seal Gloss Protection. All this only from Boral at a noteworthy price. Phone Boral Roof Restoration today and jazz up your roof.
Now, we're getting a few entries for our video camera competition, but hell, so far, there's not a lot to beat. So get to it and send your best or worst photo or video to FAB South Oz, Box 6007, Halifax Street, Adelaide 5000. There's only a couple of weeks left to win this.
It's the Canon UC6000 camcorder from Ted's Camera Store in Rundle Street. You're guaranteed to capture the best shots with the 16x optical zoom and a whole range of other magic features. The UC6000 from Canon and Ted's, of course.
Regardless of what sort of reel you own, it needs to be serviced at least once a year. If you don't feel confident to do it yourself, get an expert to help. Carmen Pescatore is something of a reel repair legend. A routine service involves dismantling, cleaning, replacing any worn parts, and reassembling, hopefully in the right order.
Well, we thought we'd take you for a ride in what must be the ultimate in toys. This is the Regal 1900 SLR. It's a speedboat, it's a ski boat, it's a kneeboard boat, it's a wakeboard boat, all in one, and you can just have a lot of fun, Andrew.
Certainly is, Steve. It's a beautiful little boat powered by a four-cylinder inboard, delivering incredible performance. I think you'd agree. It's really quite surprising. It's got all the beautiful refinements of a fully imported boat. This Regal's manufactured in Florida. And it certainly is a benchmark in family entertainment boating.
Well, it's beautifully laid out here too. It's got easy to steer. It must have power steering. It's, the dashboard's laid out nicely too. I mean, it's just a classy looking number anyway.
Oh, absolutely. The wood grain dash, the inbuilt ice box here in front of the passenger, full stereo in front of the driver, seating for seven, plenty of room down in here for the wakeboards. It's I think they've thought of everything with this boat.
I mean, life must be tough if you've got to drive one of these.
Well, I think those who've got them are certainly very impressed.
Mm. So tell me about sort of the performance of the boat. How fast will it go? How many skiers could you pull, for example?
Right, well, it generally performs around the 45 mile an hour mark, and that is derived with the four-cylinder engine with an innovative hull called the Fast Track Hull, which is a patented design of Regal, and it allows the air to get in under the hull very quickly and get the boat up on the plane, and also handles the corners well.
Okay, how many skiers?
You're probably going to pull up to three on kneeboards, and slalom, you probably get two people up.
It's a beauty just for cruising the river. I mean, or you could take it out to sea as well.
Well, that's right. It's certainly a great Coorong boat to get down amongst the sand hills and hop off on the bow straight on the beach.
Just give us the price, Andrew.
$34,500.
Complete.
Complete on trail.
Ready to go.
Ready to go. Put some petrol in, turn the key.
It's yours from Homarch Island Marina.
That's correct.
Hi, Nuala here with weather and hotspots. Unfortunately, conditions tomorrow won't be the best for boating and fishing. West to northwesterly winds of 17 to 22 knots are expected overnight, so best to leave the boat at home this weekend. High water tomorrow is at 4 o'clock in the morning, then again at 5 past 4 in the afternoon. The low water's just after 10 a.m. and 10 p.m. The Port River and West Lakes look like being good alternatives tomorrow. In the Port, try Jervois Bridge area for brim and school mulloway, and West Lakes has mullet and brim.
And that's about it for FAB South Oz this week. Next week, we have one of those nifty little hummingbird fish finders from Glasscraft Marine to give away, and a whole lot more fishing and boating action. So we'll see you then on FAB South Oz.
That's